Hello musicians, this is Andrew Mercer, and today we're going to do a very short tutorial on how to do beat matching for mashups, remixes, mixtapes. Hang on. Doing beat matching in Audacity is actually quite simple. The technology used to do it, it's not that complicated at all. You need to use your ears. Okay, that's the trick with this. Okay, you gotta use your ears. Now, this question about how to do beat matching came from one of our subscribers, Ben at Play. Thank you, Ben at Play, for this question. He wanted to know how you can do beat matching for things like mixtapes and mashups. So here we go. I actually have two songs in here that I created in GarageBand for this purpose. And I'm going to try to match up both of these songs. So I'm going to match them up in the context of trying to do it for a mixtape. Okay, so you want one song to end and gradually, with the beats matching up, go into the next song. Okay, so here's what the first song sounds like. And here's what the second song sounds like. Okay, so they have a fairly close tempo. I mean, they're pretty close to each other. Now, just to demonstrate that, let me zoom in here with my handy-dandy mouse. You'll notice that we have sounds, like this is a snare drum right here. You can see it's a darker pulse, and that's a snare drum here. And I'm pretty sure that's one there, and that's one there. Let's have a listen to make sure. I'm hitting solo on the track, you see that? So I can hear that track by itself. Solo means by itself. So let's see if this is a snare drum. Yes, it is. Hear that? Okay, so let's see if this is a snare drum. Yes, that is a snare drum too. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my time shift tool here on the tool menu. See that time shift tool? Easy stuff. Now I'm going to slide this guy over so that both of these snare drums lined up. Now, oh, I can already see the tempo not matching up already. You see, these are pretty close tempos, but you can see that the snare drum right here is already starting to be out only after like half a bar, half a measure. And look, it's even out more as you go across. These dark pulses are the snare drum beats, and generally they're on the beat. You can see they're getting wider and wider as you go across. That's because the tempo is not the same. Now, when you do a mixtape sort of thing, you don't have to have exactly the same tempo. Got to be close, but it doesn't have to be exact. Now, what I'm going to do is, with this, I want this top song to eventually reach an end somewhere around right here. Oh, can we go back? Somewhere around right here. And I want the other song to begin around that point. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'll let you hear what I want that ending to sound like. So it goes something like this. Okay, so that's basically what I want the ending to sound like. And then I want the beginning of the next song to start. And that one sounds like this. 1 second, I can't move my mouse fast enough. But that beginning sounds like this. Okay, so you can see this piece right here, this pulse right here, that is on the downbeat, right here. See that? Here it is again. Yeah, right here, that's the downbeat. So I want that pulse to line up with this pulse right here. Okay, so, and again, said you got to use your ears for this stuff. I mean, it's easy to get a piece of software to do it for you, but you want this. You want to do this yourself. You're musicians. Okay, so now I just did that. I used my time shift tool to move over piece number two so the pulse is lined up. And I'm using my my in and out zoom to have a look at that. Okay, let's move back a little bit and try and see what it sounds like. Not too bad. Let's go back a little bit further and see. Actually, you know what? I'm in the wrong place. I was zoomed in so close I couldn't even see. I want to get rid of all this. I want all this to go. So I want, let's go back to right here. And I'll get rid of that with my delete key. And now I'm going to my shift tool back. Again, so you got to use your ears. I said you got to use your ears, and I picked up on a little mistake I made. So now let's zoom in again. There we go. Zooming in there. And now, this is the pulse that I want, and I want it to line up right there on that pulse, so it's right there. Let me zoom back out a bit. It's a little clearer if it's out a bit. Now, I've got to go back in again. And again, you got to use your eyeballs, you got to use your ears. Now, let's move back and see if it stays in time. Check it out. Now, that sounds pretty cool if you ask me. Let's go back and listen to it again. There you go. Match pitches, match beats, match beats. So there you go, guys. Nothing to it. That's pretty straightforward. Now, if you have any comments or concerns or questions, put it in the discussion section down here in the bottom, please. Also, give me a thumbs up. If this is good, you like it, it's what you want, give me a thumbs up. I know I'm doing a good job. And if you, and subscribe. Keep track of new videos. Subscribe. Okay, guys. Good luck. See you next time.